Okay, so I hope everyone's doing okay. I just want to mention that I was talking to someone this morning, and I just discovered this great website. Actually, it's on Facebook. The name of it is Melrose Foodie, F-O-O-D-I-E. A graduate of Melrose High School, Jeff McNaught, who is now councilman in Melrose, put this together, and it's really a good, there's a lot of good information on there referred to, and I just looked it up, and it could be something that's worth checking out. Okay, so today, I don't know if this music's too loud. Today I'm going to make chicken cacciatore. This is the most easy recipe. I know I say that to everything that I make, but this is very easy. It's quick, okay? I'm gonna have to move the camera at one point because it's all stove stuff except for the chicken. I rinsed the chicken out. I'm using chicken thighs. Okay, so now we have chicken thighs. Okay, the name of this song is Someday. You know, someday we'll all be back to normal, semi-normal. Okay, get back to this chicken cacciatore. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna trim the fat off. Okay, my husband loves this. I'm just gonna trim some fat off, make them a little, make them a little smaller, make the pieces a little smaller. Okay, and, I'm gonna make them just so you can just pick them up and eat them, because these are boneless. These are boneless chicken thighs. I got them at Whole Foods. They look pretty good. Okay. And this is one package, but it's like a pound and maybe a pound and a quarter. But like I say, it's real quick. I'm gonna blink and it's gonna be all over. Just wanna update you, just another story, update you with something. I discovered today a few things. I watched a few of the videos that I put together. And like I say, I don't have a cameraman. The camera's on a piece of wood molding my husband made. I mean, he didn't make the molding. He put the thing you take the pictures with, you go like this with, that pole that you would stand. He put that on the top of this molding, and he put it in a bucket. It's in a bucket. The molding's in a bucket. And he made it so it's stationary. And he just taped the extension. What do you call it? You take your selfies with it. But anyway, so he taped that around the pole, so that around the piece of wood, so that I could put the camera on the top. And that is why people say, Connie, why are your eyes? Sometimes you just see your eyes. It's because I can't reach the camera. It's up high. So I'm like this. So what you're getting is my eyes. And my daughter, Erin, has been editing. She's doing a good job editing the videos. And in some of them, you do see my eyes. And my other daughter thinks it's funny that you just see my eyes. So just, you know, we'll keep it in there. It's in there and it's not in there. It's in some of them and it's not in some of them. So, whatever. Okay, so this meat seems to be pretty clean. Watch Rachel Ray cook in her kitchen. She's got this thing, it's a big scooper. It just grabs all the stuff. When she slices the thing, it grabs it and she throws it in the dish. Let me see if I have something like that. I don't think I do. I have this little thing. But I'll try it. I'll get the idea. You'll get the idea. See, it goes like this. This way I don't have to handle it. I noticed in the videos that I looked at this morning. I don't know, especially now touching food, I'm learning. Okay, what I'm gonna do is, grab my bottle of oil. I think I keep them in business. I think a lot of people keep them in business. The extra virgin olive oil. I'm just gonna line the pan. Okay, put the gas on to medium. One thing about doing this little thing that I'm doing, at least you're gonna have to get dressed up, because otherwise you wouldn't know what time it is, you don't know what day it is, you don't have to get dressed up, but at least this is taking up some of my time, I'm enjoying it, and I'd love the feedback. All right. This is heating up. Believe it or not, I don't use garlic in this dish. Just heat up the oil. I'm gonna put the chicken breast that I cut up. I didn't cut them too small. You know, they were good size. These are good size pieces, okay? I'm just gonna put them in the oil. Sizzling. Okay. I'll let that sizzle for a little bit. So now I'm at the stove and the chicken is frying. I wouldn't say it's frying. It's like sauteing in the oil. Okay. Sizzling. Okay, look, the music. It's just like sizzling in the oil. Okay, and now, this song is summertime. I can't wait for the summer. Okay, so now the rosemary, important part. Just sprinkle it over the sizzling chicken breast that I cut up. It always looks like, I noticed that too in the video, it always looks like I'm sprinkling a lot, but I'm really not. It's really not coming up, but I just keep sprinkling and with the cheese and everything else. I just keep, I don't know, I think I'm a chef. Okay, so this is cooking now with the rosemary. And if you know, if you're familiar with rosemary, it has a distinct aroma, smell, stink. Okay, but it doesn't stink, it's aroma. Okay, so you just make sure it's just all, mostly all the chicken is covered with the rosemary. Okay? So, pepper. I'm going to open the bottom of this because it has a problem coming out. Pepper. Salt. A pepper flakes. I think I put this in almost everything I make. Okay. It's really not coming up. Okay. As you can see, it's just sitting here doing its business in the oil. The chicken breasts are doing their business in the oil. Okay, chicken breast turns like white, like they're almost like steamed versus fried. I think that's what they're doing, is steaming more than frying. It's like the other day I made something. Oh, the artichokes are steaming. They're not cooking, they're steaming. Okay. So good. Okay, salt, pepper. I've already used that, used that, used that, used this. Red wine vinegar. I thought about putting wine in it, but I didn't want to take a chance. But I think you could, I don't know, maybe you could, but it would have to be a red wine. But this red wine vinegar is excellent. Okay, so you just pour this over it. Okay. I should have measured that. I would say a half a cup. Or just put it so it's just, put enough in there that it's almost covering it. Okay? It's almost covering the chicken. Okay. And then, I can't remember if I'm going to let it simmer. Yeah, so you let it simmer. And, let it simmer for a little bit. I'm gonna cut some of these chunks up. Take that to the bank. So it's simmering. Tastes quick. Okay, so now I'm gonna put in the Hunt's tomato sauce. This is a 29-ounce can of Hunt's tomato sauce. I always put a little water in here just to get the rest of it out of the pan. Second. See, I just stir it up just to get the rest of the tomatoes out of the pan. Can of peas. That's it. gravy on the shrimp. Sauce on the shrimp. Okay, that's it. I'll let it cook for a little bit. I think it's like 30 minutes. You have to let it simmer and cook for like 30 minutes, okay? But I'll be back and I'll show you the chicken cacciatore. I'm back, and here's the chicken cacciatore with peas. Okay, it took like 20 minutes. It just all simmered, you know, and cooked, covered. You might have to cut the pieces of chicken, okay, to make it a good size. And I did sprinkle mock-bashed Parmesan cheese. You could use this, the pecorino cheese on it. The most important part is bread. Okay, just dunk it in the sauce. I call this sauce, but I call my pasta gravy. The red stuff is gravy. Okay, it's not sauce, but this is sauce. This is chicken cacciatore with the peas and the sauce. Oh. Really good. Another success story. Whoops. God bless you. Sneezed. Okay. Thanks for watching.